trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Hello. misty watercolor memories of the way we were. Scattered pictures of the smiles we left behind, smiles we gave to one another.
Why hasn't he called me? All of a sudden, I see two arms reaching out of his soul. He had fallen down the sewer line. I don't know how he did it, but he was down the hole. Now, let's get out of the fun of working, and let's go into fun. He says, Mike, he says, you're going hunting. He says, why not bring me along? I says, fine, Raj, no problem, come on. So I said, Raj, you stay here. I'm in the canoe, and I've got my shotgun. I said, I'm gonna go over to the island where there's another blind. You stay in this one. And I says, as the ducks come through, we got them on a cross pattern. He says, come on, Mike, I wanna go with you. And he steps right on the edge of the canoe. Needless to say, as I swam to the top of the water, pulling my shotgun, he was in the water with me. It was thin ice on the lake. We were both frozen. But that's all right. That was part of being with Roger. We love him dearly. I can go on and on. And it's nothing but fun from Roger. Top it off, folks. He hasn't changed. He hasn't changed.
He's still a child.
He went to the auction with me. Major League's got to get involved. He cannot back away from something. And I told him, Raj, and I says, look, I says, when you go to the auction, you got to be careful. I says, you got to inspect the cars. You got to know what you're buying. And here all these cars were coming through, and Roger is standing there, and he's... He says, Mike, you mind if I bid on a car? And I says, Rod, I says, fine. If you find a car you want, bid on it. I don't see him. He disappears. Long, he comes and he says, Mike, I found one. I bought one. You got to come with me. And I says, okay, Rod, what'd you buy? He says, this fantastic Cadillac. Black Cadillac. I says, okay. We go out to inspect the car. I sit in the car, and there's cockroaches all over the car. It has an odor that I couldn't even stand sitting in the car. He says, Mike, you gotta get rid of this car. I said, Raj. I said, how am I gonna get rid of it? In the meantime, I bought a car for my wife. He says, Raj says to me, Mike, can I have that car? And I said, no problem. He said, but get rid of the Cadillac. So he hasn't changed, folks. And because of that, we love him. Because it's fun, fun, fun.
I'd like to draw your attention to the picture on the screen here. This is the second time we saw Roger do physical breathing. Anita tells me he cut the grass once, he ran the thing into a couple of rocks, broke the blade, and he says, it's your job. She's done it ever since. And to continue with that, I'd like to read a few comments from the letters I have from people who could not make it today. Take off his shirts, his street clothes at a hockey game, and don a cheerleader outfit, pom-poms and all, and cheer on the parents of an 8-year-old boy at 20 below zero. Who could that be? Eat 9 hot dogs in 6 holes of golf and can't wait to get to the 4th turn so he can get 3 more. Sell water softeners door to door and go into the people's John and stay there until they agree to buy a new softener. Hit the ugliest, heaviest, cluttiest Bob Towski club golf clubs you ever saw and continually sell them and tell about their merits and then ultimately add 50 yards immediately to his stroke as he purchased pings. I need to give me another person back there. Who do you think said that, Robert?
Well, I must say, if you had to choose a neighbor,
this is incredible.
You choose Roger Wilson. Why I said that, and I'm talking about Minnesota. Picture summertime in Minnesota.
That's 2 days.
We typically mow the lawn at the same time and would wave to one another as we about a year ago, we painted our house, and Roger said, I want to paint the second story. I love to climb ladders. Then he did a fine job. He truly did. In the wintertime, it was the darndest thing. He would shovel his driveway and would have it all done before we even got out of bed and would come over and help us. Oh, and last but not least, if your battery went dead, the first fellow you would call would be Roger Wilson. He would be over with his tools, his all of the cords and what have you, and help you out. Now, if you believe anything that I've said,
Anita, don't let him come out yet.
Now, I've got a lot of property on the Gaza Strip that I'll sell you quite cheaply. But Well, I'm proud of you. I want you, this gentleman here is the second partner of what we call the Doolittle Brothers. Roger and Ron are the Doolittle Brothers. They are both retired well into their early 40s, right? And here they are today, after 5 years of doing nothing, still complaining about one another. Ron, come out of here. And Evie. Because I know you can't read very fast. Don and I were planning to come to Florida for your party, but we got a letter from the IRS. We owe $5.25. A person cannot plan ahead. You save all your life and then pay it all to the government. So here's your card. Please read it to the audience.
Mommy, do you have my glasses?
Mommy, he's sugar man, I'm now second man.
Jesus loves you. Everyone else thinks you're an asshole.
Fantastic $150 a night dinner and stop at White Castle on your way home. Invite two couples to breakfast and eat half the eggs before they get there. Be waited on hand and foot by a girl from Indiana who cooks, washes dishes, cuts the lawn, changes storm window, and places your phone calls, and gets by with a simple "I love you more than you love me." Gets half the population of Minnesota to fly one halfway across the country to celebrate his birthday. Anita, you're on. Give me somebody else.
Ode to Roger Wilson, our friend and neighbor. Who is that guy who's just turned 50? Pat and Beebe think he's nifty.
Who is that dude who thinks he's nifty? One look at him and you know he's 50.
At times he really can be crass.
But he's got a heart as big as his ass.
Got it made.
Yes, she's always sitting in his shade.
We hear he's quite the athlete too.
Yeah, one flight of stairs and he turns blue.
When Roger wades in our great long lake,
it's like the great San Francisco quake.
In the sex department, he's no flop.
But Anita has to be among the top. Roger, you love us more than we love you.
As his friends are gathered here to wish him joy on his 50th year. Winter seems long when you're away. Roger Sugarman, you're okay.
Your water softened. Here's the people to talk to. Now, a little on the positive side, I'd like to read a few comments from some of the people. Roger Wilson, the one who taught me, it's okay to hug another man and say I love you without getting arrested. He's always there when you need him. He's truly convinced that you'll be with him. Always sends first brackets when our fruit baskets when someone is sick. A fair friend, one who continually annihilates friends. Happy birthday, we love you, Sonny and Jim. Could not be here today, Jim. Roger. I want you to understand that. Anita, I think you have a few more people for us.
Roger, do you remember one time we took the boat out to Lake Johanna? We had a little problem out there that day. Here's somebody that wants to remind you of it.
It all started when we invited Anita and Roger to go boating with us on Lake Johanna. We were cruising around for a while and my husband asked Roger, if he'd like to drive the boat. He got this gleam in his eye and he said yes. And he got behind that wheel, pushed down the throttle, and drove like crazy. Can we tip this boat, he asked Kurt. Kurt says, I don't think so. And we all started praying as he tried to tip the boat. We didn't know how we were going to stop him, but after what seemed like hours, we finally ran out of gas. Of course, we were on the far end of the lake with no oars.
It's difficult, right, Mike?
And had to get out and swim and push the boat to shore. He had to buy his own boat to go boating after that.
Kurt and Joni Craig again from New Brighton. Where else? Roger, I will remember the biggest, best, and most successful sales talent that Lindsay Company ever had. You won the only gold Cadillac contest. We made the trip from St. Paul to Carlene, Iowa. Jesus, man. Well, at least we take them to Phoenix in our company on a fifth of Johnny Red, and you gave a speech. You are the only guy in North America to get first class seats at a tourist price from Chicago to Florida in United Airlines because you weren't comfortable. Billy Graham is a great salesman, but you are so far superior that you convinced an ordained Lutheran minister to leave the pulpit and become the software dealer, or soft water dealer. Another match you can belt on your victory. But Raj, do you know how to have and make people want to join you? At the New Orleans convention, we have the hospitality suites, complete with booze, snacks, and the works. I don't know what that means. However, your personal suite was more crowded all night than all the others. The beautiful Anita was a big asset to your many accomplishments too. We love you more than you love us.
No way.
Charlie and Jolynn, they aren't here tonight. Unfortunately. So Anita, let's give us a couple of this year.
Nothing would surprise me.
Hi, Roger. I'm one of your new friends, married to one of your old friends, and I just want to say I'm glad I could be here with you tonight because I'm glad I'm one of your new friends.
Who's that, Roger? Dave has a few words to say.
Not too many, Roger. Ladies and gentlemen, we go back a long time, Roger and I, and I was thinking about some nice things to say because you've got a lot of comical friends in there. But during the Second World War, the London press asked for statements or a little phrase as to what a friend was. And the best thing that came in was that a friend is a person who comes in and picks up all the pieces from the rest of the world who've gone out. And this guy has many kind, with a lot of people have come in and picked up many pieces. Ron, it's great to be with you.
Fred tells me he taught everything to Roger that he knows. Anita, do we have somebody back there?
What we left was suite 117B at the Metrodome. The date was a Second World Series playoff game. The situation was we were trying to get back to your house to have a party. And we were in need of a lane change on the freeway, and there was a traffic jam. And Roger got out of the shotgun seat, which he insisted on, stopped all the traffic in the left lane so I could get in the lane so we could proceed to get home.
She said, to Fort Myers, Florida. And I said, Fort Myers, Florida? I said, that's where I live. And she said, you do? And I said, yes. I said, didn't they say anything about contacting us? And she said, no. And I said, how long have they been there? She says, oh, they've been there 3-4 days. And I said, well, gosh, if they call you, would you tell them to call me? She said, what's your number? I said, you mean they don't have it? And she said, I don't think so. So I gave her the number, and I told Anita, I said, Anita, can you believe that? I said, they came to Fort Myers, and they didn't even call us. You guys are bad. Thanks.
Roger, I got so many letters here. Nia, what have we got there? 1.5 or 3.5 or 19.5 people?
Roger, we had planned to roast you, but you do much better as the rare person you are, and you're in danger of being overdone tonight.
Thank you. Roger, a little note here. Well, you finally made it. 50 years old, we must let some famous and not so famous people share your feelings about the milestones in life. Birth is the first. To your embarrassment, you were born in bed with a lady. Childhood, we became adults when we started to realize that we are no longer young enough to know anything. Marriage. After marriage, we all said, my wife and I are now married and just as happy as we were before. That's your second milestone, right? You are the one that can still make the statement. Children. Insanity is hereditary. You can get it from your children. Young adults, between 25 and 35, you're too young to do anything well. After 35, you're too old. Middle age, don't worry about middle age, you've outgrown it. Grandchildren, and a man that is a fool about his children will certainly be a damn fool about his grandchildren. Florida, have you ever noticed what golf spells backwards? 50 years ago, how do you tell a man that reaches the age of 50, he ain't hard? Sorry we couldn't attend your party. Have a happy birthday. Roger, we love you. John and Kay Kimmel. Okay. I think you have someone else back there. Really, Anton, now I'd like to see, there's several people out in the audience that would like to say a few words. Especially Lee Green. Where are you, Lee?
One night. poem is, Roger Wilson is a big, fine lad. Usually good, but this time he was bad. He played Friday night tennis and had lots of fun. But after that is when the trouble begun. We all went to the lounge for a little joy, and that's when he was a real bad boy. Egging him on was Sandy and Bob, and of course Norm was doing a very good job. David and Doris had an ear to the jokes and enjoying it as much as the rest of the folks. We all were laughing, but we all got up to dance. Then Roger got up and pulled down his pants. He looked at the crowd as Jerry played his tune, and with a grin on his face, gave them all the moon. That's the truth. Anita screamed, "Roger, not this place!" Then embarrassingly said, "Oh well, that's sugar face."
Sitting now with the village, the gingerbread village. Beautiful. And so that is the background of the story. And this is an ode to Sir Roger the Rowdy. This is the story of a generous man that we met, and a gingerbread auction, which we will not soon forget. The man was Roger Wilson. The day was quite warm. The forest in its Christmas garb, Roger was in rare form. Now the gingerbread village had houses, churches, and a train, and was baked by a master chef, I hasten to explain. The proceeds to help those in need of food and to help them brighten their holiday mood. Anita and Roger Wilson invited Sona and me to join in the fun and the festivity. The brunch was followed by champagne all day, and the auction, each piece was unique in its way. Roger bid on the first. Others joined in, but Roger kept bidding because he wanted to win. With a sign, a gingerbread home that he gave, but Roger kept bidding, he wanted to win, a gingerbread home that he gave to my spouse with a sign, Sona's Pad, on top of the house. The next item up was a snow-covered chalet. Roger raised each bid till it went his way. The champagne kept coming, and we were feeling no pain. Said Anita, "Let's give it to Bebe Dufresne." The next item Roger bid on was a church with a steeple.
Sugar baby.
Anita said.
We're running out of people.
The bidding went higher. Roger didn't care. The spirit of fun and goodwill permeated the air. As the day slipped away and the bidding kept going, Roger's gingerbread collection kept growing and growing. Whenever Roger's bid was topped by a guy, Anita would let out a heartfelt sigh. Her face would be wreathed in a sunny smile. Her sigh of relief could be heard up to a mile. But when Roger bid, Anita would say, under her breath, in her cute little way, "Knock it off, Roger. My sugar baby, or I'll kill you, Roger, and I don't mean maybe." Roger, not one little bit. He was on a roll, and with the sharpest of wit. Now the whole clubhouse was excited. And do you know why? They were beginning to say, "Who the hell is this guy?" He had come to the auction known by only a few, but by now all knew Roger and Anita too. Well, they kept bringing endless amounts of champagne. So Roger would bid on the last item, the train. The train was superb, a work of art on the loose, with engine, coal tender, passenger car, and caboose. Roger made the first bid. Others kept it going. The amount in direct proportion to the champagne that was flowing. When someone topped Roger, Anita would say, "Thank God. We have no place to keep it anyway." Well, Roger topped each bid in a voice good and loud and tickled the fancy of all of the crowd. "Sugar baby, I'll kill you," was heard loud and clear each time Roger bid. But he showed no fear. So in the end, it was obvious and plain that Roger had outbid all for the gingerbread train. Well, we laughed so darn much our ribs were still hurting. No comedian was ever as funny, that's certain. So we weaved our way to their home at the end of the day, loaded down with the train, houses, church, and chalet. And to this day, we will long remember generous Roger's contribution to the 25th of December.
Tony and Walt Meyer. Absolutely phenomenal. Anybody else out there we would like to make a few comments? Here we go.
Jess and Dottie Hartwood. Who is this Roger we all speak about? Is he something special or just a big clout? Jovial he is, controversial he's not. What you see is what you've got. You see a lot when you look at Rog. In a crowded room, he's hard to dodge. But he's never so big he forgets a friend. To that, I'm certain you'll all say amen. He's been called a lot by his fellow man. I once heard him referred to as a whole plan. But Roger just smiled and took it in stride. In fact, he responded, "I've too much to hide." His golf game is pure like the driven snow. It takes a long time. He's a little bit slow. But when it's all over and time to settle, Roger's a winner, a true test of metal. This guy likes to party, and when out on a fling, a couple of belts and he's ready to sing. A half dozen more and he's ready to soar. Say what you want, Roger's never a bore. And now that he's 50 and over the hill, one look and it's obvious he's been through the mill. But he's still full of fun. No, excuse me. He's still full of life with a yen for fun. He's a jolly good-looking son of a gun. And Roger, in closing, we wish you the best. But along with that, we have one request. Don't ever change. Keep that smile on your pan, because we all think you're one hell of a man.
Anybody else out there? There we go.
I don't have a speech or anything. I just have one thing to say to this man. I fell in love with him tonight. And I just want to say one thing, Roger. You the best damn Yankee to come down here.
Nickname that nobody will give him because they love him so much, and that's Minnesota Fats. Nobody calls him that. Nobody calls him that. Everybody's had a lot of O's tonight, and I've got an O to a Grecian urn. There once was a young man named Roger, who at golf was quite an artful dodger, with a girth magnifique. But with a disposition so sweet, all the girls want him for their romantic lodger.
Love it. Anybody else out there? Roger, I think the group is going a little quiet here.
All right.
So I've got a present here that I've been told that I have to open. So excuse me a second.
Dana, you're bad, honey.
Wonderful.
You really got me.
She loves you more than you love her.
No way.
The big 50, it says. Roger is sure and quite unseemly that you are 50 and extremely. And though it seems like quite a ploy, 5 decades have turned a man to a boy. From common birth and humble start, from poor young man to rich old fart, you have excelled in leaps and bounds, weighing at least 300 pounds. And one smart choice you made in life was choosing Anita as your wife. Thank God she didn't leave you alone, or both your kids would be named Tyrone. Both cold and snow cannot be beat. We have made Flora your winter retreat. Florida, excuse me.
Florida.
Florida? Is that the way I said Florida? But those of us as stranded up here, it's much a bummer because we're glad to see you back here each summer. And though I will not read a litany, you are loved by Brandon, Dustin, and Brittany. They are glad to visit their old granddad because he was a Lincoln and a can. You shall go in for Rolfing. You spend your days with sports and golfing. It must be a horrible, boring life. So free, so care, so free of strife. And for your birthday, I search for rags of Gucci, Tiffany, and of Saks. For something sweet that I could give you, I chose a poem that might outlive you. So there's always a time to play. Serious Roger, have a birthday. And though I risk my life in penalty, let me remind you, your 50 is one half a century. We wish for you another 50 years for the best God to offer. We love you more. The white.
The white.
Wytrek.
David.
Oh,
Shirley Wytrek.
So I can get a picture of Wytrek.
That is really good, Shirley. I didn't think you had it in you.
Come on, David.
Oh, David.
Come on, I want to get a picture.
You can't walk.
Oh, yes. Come on, David. Come on, David. That was neat. Did you do any of that?
Shirley, I'm quite sure you have a few choice words.
You did all of it?
For the turkey.
I want both of you to hug Roger so I can get a picture of the two of them.
Sherman and Davy Wytrek are Sherman. Shirley and David Wytrek are Roger and Anita's
outlaws.
Outlaws. Their son is married to Tara.
That's right. You got it right.
You got that right.
No.
This is a party, and there's a champagne glass with me floating in it with a boat, and there's a parrot about, must be Bummer, Garnet, and Bummer's got a fish that's hanging down. I got my mouth open, he's going to drop it in my mouth, in the and I'm laying in the champagne glass on my back swimming. Then there's a bottle of Perrier and a cake and a minstrel band and a boat in the background and the palm trees and a birthday cake. This is quite a deal. I don't know how they put it together, but thank you very much. Love you guys.
I understand we have a late arriving guest. We had a blowout, missed his plane, rented a car, and had to drive down here. Do I get some comments out there from the right?
Should look. I'm his much, much younger brother. Anyway, Nate asked me to say something funny. I couldn't think of anything funny to say, but usually when I see my brother, it's just enough time that we get together and hug and tell each other we love each other. And I do love you. He's probably the most kind, honest, integrity, moral, upright, and I respect him a great deal. Now, get on to serious stuff. Oh, with the mic, sorry about that. Well, I don't know what to say, brother. Love you. You're a very special person.
How are you?
Yes, and
front of you a spoon. I want you to tell you what Roger does at all of the dinner meetings, the dinner dates, or the dinner parties that they have in Minnesota. He is great at this. Let's see if we can all hang a spoon on your nose. It's very easy. I'll give him one.
Hey, Tom.
Look at that! Wow! Hey, I see many out in the audience that can do that too, you know? It's just absolutely phenomenal! Wait a minute, I got a word. Ruth wants to say something. Ruth! say something? Come on. No. I got a few words I got to say here.
I'm going to get my glasses down so I can read it.
Happy birthday, Rod. You are very bad. Fred, Nan, and Allison. Dear Raj, on this occasion of your 50th birthday celebration arranged by the enduring Anita, we wish to participate in spirit since we were not possibly physical. Although we had to mask the elongation of your litigation in this song, here's just hoping you have the happiest birthday ever. We are very proud to have such a loving, talented, and esteemed nephew. Much love, Bud and Jean. P.S. If you would read the lyrics of the Bad as only you can, the party guest will be, well, I would tell you, highly entertained.
I guess I'm supposed to read this. This is a song named Bad.
Sing it.
Your butt is mine. I'm gonna tell you right. Just show your face in broad daylight. I'm telling you how I feel. Gonna hurt your mind. Don't shoot to kill. Come on, come on, lay it on me. All right. He goes back. Well, they say the sky's the limit, and to me that's really true. But my friend, you have seen nothing. Just wait till I get through. Because I'm... I'm bad. Come on, you know I'm bad. I'm bad. You know it. You know I'm bad. Come on, you know. And the whole world has to answer right. Now, just to tell you once again, who's bad? The word is out, you're doing wrong. Gonna lock you up before too long. Your lying eyes. Gonna tell you right, so listen up, don't make a fight. Your talk is cheap, you're not a man. You're throwing stones to hide your hands. We can know it, you know. Woo, woo, woo. You know I'm bad. Come on. You know I'm bad. I'm bad. You know it. You know it. You know. You know. You know. You know. Come on. And the whole world has to answer right now just to tell you, you know I'm telling you once again. Who's bad?
Jackson, you're dead.
Who's that from?
Bud.
Why no Bud?
Bud.
Now, how many of you people have had Roger and Anita over to you? Give me a head count out there. Raise your hands. How many of you people have gone out to dinner with Roger and Anita?
Yay!
Hey, we got a good crowd here. Now, you know the thing that amazes me about those two? You know, they got this dignity. They think they're high class. They think they're up there in the class A friends. Leave me tell you. Jeez.
Doris, give me the next slide.
This is what happens at a dinner party.
This is the way the Rilsons really act. This is the way out of New Soul.
Shot by Alvin Walker.
Are you
Alvin Bryant.
some butts with candy and nuts. What a lovely Christmas we have.
How about my kings?
Roger's letter.
I don't know. Why are they going short instead of underneath?
What else
was a gain of 7.
So what?
How many seconds?
1 minute.
There's all kinds of seconds.
Six. Oh, Brittany, what are we gonna do?
Come over here, Dylan.
I don't know. I'm thinking 7 points, however we can get it. I'm not fussy about the technique.
Everybody get ready to hold. Get ready to hold because this is the time right now.
Hold. Don't fumble.
Selleck.
Happy birthday again.
Thank you.
This is the real day, I understand.
Oh, yes, this is it.
Thanks, Bill. Appreciate it.
Play us a tune for the video here.
Well, all right.
One of your favorites.
My favorite. Oh, my goodness. Well, let me see. I'm going to try a new song here. Let's see what I can play it.
Mr. Roger Wilson on the keyboard.
Thank you.
Tampa. Story that's been going on for a long time.
Normal way, all
check and didn't drop off that much or go up that high for most people that come from out of state to this country. I'm telling you all I know, folks. Good luck, all. I think the polls are divisible by 9. Pretty peril.
Just below Sean.
Peter!